Hey, welcome back to the shop, everybody. What I got going here today is actually started yesterday, but this is a pallet. You can see there's an old pallet down here. I added the wheels and the boards underneath so I can get up off the ground and make it mobile, because I'm making a mobile container garden that can roll around anywhere, roll around out by the shop or by the patio or whatever. Since it doesn't look as nice, I'll probably just use this for gardening down here by the barn or whatever, away from the house. But something I thought of, because I had this pallet laying around and these big caster trucks, they were on one of my old generators. I built a frame stand for the generator that I used to have before I got the new one, and this is how I got it around. So I took that all apart, put the wheels up underneath here, and I took you can see the 2x6s out front, and then I added some 2x4s right here, so we get about the same level all the way across. Now that gives me about, I want to say 11 inches depth there of soil. So the soil that I have out back, that I've had for years, I'm going to put in here. I'm also going to build some framing around each one of these sides. So I have probably a 1x framing around each side with the screen. And I think on this side right here, I'm going to put like a door so I can reach in, because we can pretty much reach over all the way to get to any of the vegetables or whatever we need to. So, and it's going to be easy to put on a top if I had to put on a top. Not sure about that yet. I might make a hinge top. I might just not make a top at all, something I can throw on and off. But it all depends. I just plan on doing some probably tomatoes and some peppers in here. Maybe some cilantro too, because that stuff's easy to grow. Just stuff that we eat a lot of. Stuff that we need close to the house, and something we can keep an eye on, because all the deer and all the rabbits and everything are back there at the big garden, and very hard to control that yet until I get that all secured in. But I think I'm going to like this, and at least, hey, why not learn from it, right, and see what happens. So, another thing too, as you can see, this pallet's got the fork pockets down there on all sides. See the fork pockets down there? So I can get the bobcat up here and move it around wherever I want. I can take it anywhere. I can even load it up in my truck, take it somewhere else. So this thing's gonna be really cool. What I put in here so far, you can see the gray fabric. This is just landscape fabric. These the lumber that I used is non-treated pine, so I know it won't last too long, but it's not gonna be outside all winter either, just in the summertime. So there's, you know, obviously you don't want to use, you know, green wood, womanized wood. It's not coming in direct contact with any plastic. And that organic soil that I make is going to be good. So next step is I'm going to get these side panels on and probably go get a bucket load of dirt, that good soil, and put it in here. And then I'll let you know where we're at once we get there. You can see all the sides are on now. Here's the gate. I included the chicken wires on all these little panels. And I even put a little latch. This is how I'm gonna get into the small garden and be able to reach all the vegetables and everything. Now you see that it's from here, this is where the dirt's gonna fill up to. From here down to the bottom here, it's about 11 inches. What I'm going to do now is take this other piece of screen that I have. It's the same 4x4 little grid here, and it's going over the top. So it's going to lay right in here. I left a gap, about an inch and a half gap, so a 2x4 frame will go into the top of this. And I'm thinking about putting some hinges, I don't know, maybe over here, across from the door or to the side. I'm not sure yet. So I'm going to lay that in there, get it all cut up, put the cage on top. Now, I probably won't be able to use it for tomatoes, because tomatoes are going to get way taller than this. But who knows? I might not even use the top at all. I just don't know what the animals are going to do right now, and you know how they're going to figure this cart out yet. So we'll see how that goes. But, hey, it's all experimental, right? The stuff that goes in the ground back there in the garden is going to stay there. But I think this is going to be really cool when it's done, and It'd be cool to watch and see how things grow in this thing and see how this protects it from all the critters. So let's get started with this top, and then I'm gonna take you guys outside and we'll get some soil, some of my good soil back there, and get the bobcat out and get to filling this thing up today. All right. That is some black gold right there. Isn't that great, you guys? Like I said before, what I've been doing is I make my own soil. And what it is years and years worth of compost from our landscaping cleanups. There's some, it's mostly leaves or sticks. There's everything that's in the yard. The clean stuff. I don't take any spray and all that stuff. This is just the clean. Now look at this. This has been, the pile that this came from is, I think it's a 4-year-old pile. I have some that's a 20-year-old pile. That stuff is like mud. But look at this. I'm gonna put my hand in here. And this is like a gardener's and a farmer's dream right here. Check this out. So I have 11 inches deep in here, right? Look at this. You guys see that? That is just black gold. And it smells so good. There's worms in it. There's some pine needles in it. You still see the leaves that are breaking down. What I'm gonna like about this is that it's gonna be easy to reach in here and pull weeds. I decided I'm going to bring it out here right now and get it out in the sun and let it start warming up, because the pile it came from is pretty cold back there. So I'm gonna start getting this soil all into its new spot here, and then I'll be taking chicken manure out of the coop over there. I'm gonna go get some of that in a little while, get that going in here, because pretty soon I'll be putting, I think we're gonna do lettuce, peppers, onions, just small rows, just stuff that we use every week. Like I said, this is a test run to see how this thing is going to work. It's like the ultimate mobile container garden. I think it's going to be cool. Oh yeah, I don't know if I showed you guys. Look at this top. Now that top is there just to keep, and it goes down in there. I got to adjust it because it's on a hill right now. But what I did is, I even put this up. Look. Oh, you can't even see it, but I put up a little stand so that it can hold itself up and not hit us in the head. Pretty good, huh? Oh yeah, so nice. All right, so from this point on, what we're gonna do is I'll go through my seed store, and I'm gonna get the seeds. I'm gonna start germinating them. I think I still have kale left over. I got a couple packets of that. We'll start germinating seeds, peppers too. I have those onion bulbs. So here's some onion seeds, or onion starting bulbs. Let me show you. These are, I think they're Vidalia Golds, or just Vidalias, look at that. So I'm gonna get some of these, I get a row of these in here. They don't take up a whole lot of space, but they're gonna be in a small row like this. And I'll have them buried, but that's kind of how they go. So we got Vidalia, peppers, cilantro, kale, some romaine lettuce, I believe, yeah. Just some of our favorite things, things that we like to eat all the time, but don't let that Rona get you down. Do stuff. Be self-sufficient. Be prepared. And critically think.